As we continue to increase our acclaim, more potential partners become willing to work with us. We can now approach an additional sponsor from the corporate tab. How do you want us to deal with this one? Thanks for stepping in and helping handle that. I know we were expecting some new developments to come through, but some of them have failed quality control. We'll need to tell.
We're all ready for tomorrow's race, but before we begin, let's have a quick look at those who will be fronting the grid. Hamilton, Bottas, and Sergio Perez. Goodbye for now then, but we're really just getting started. Make sure to join us again for Lights Out tomorrow.
Tough luck there. It's not quite where we'd want to be on the grid, but chin up, it's not the end of the world.
Good afternoon and welcome to Baku. This was the arena, if you think back to 2017, of one of the most eventful races of modern history, with controversy behind the safety car, last second overtakes, and a historic podium for Williams and for Lance Stroll. So let's find out what lies in store for us this year. It's time for the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. Baku's city circuit then, an unpredictable 3.7 mile track around the streets of the Azerbaijan capital. 20 turns for our drivers to navigate today, including the infamous Turn 8, one of the tightest and most challenging corners of the season. And as always, a man with plenty of racing experience joins me in the commentary box. Today, it's Anthony Davidson. Tell me, Ant, you're no stranger to surviving the melee of Turn 1. So how do you keep out of trouble when there's so much going on around you?
Well, the throttle goes both ways, Crofty. You've got to have the discipline not to try and win the race on the first lap. So always be prepared to lift early and give those around you more space. Trying to be the last of the late breakers with half a dozen cars around you may pay off from time to time, but it's also a great way to lose your front wing.
Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks for today's race. Lewis Hamilton lines up on pole position, and it's Valtteri Bottas that completes the front row. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Perez, Norris, Daniel Ricciardo, and Leclerc, Sainz, Gasly, Stroll, and Fernando Alonso, Ocon, Verstappen, Kimi Raikkonen, and Giovinazzi, Mick Schumacher, Russell, Nicholas Latifi, and Nikita Mazepin, Tsunoda. They'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty. Joker, Vettel, and Louis Delatraz. It's almost time for those five red lights to go out. Then let's see who can prevail today.
Engine. Let's try and keep the revs down. Early upshifts, later downshifts. We're accumulating some wear on the MGUK. To manage this, we'll need to lower our ERS deployment mode. We're reaching a danger point with the wear on the MGUH. Overheating the engine will exacerbate the issue, so keep the temps under control. we're approaching the pit window, you'll be on the mediums. Louis is coming in for his stop. Increasing the gap on the car behind by 5/10 per lap. The gap to the car ahead is 1.5 seconds. In this lap, push now. Feet, go now. That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops. Expect to see some rain about 10 to 15 minutes from now. Gap to teammate behind is 14.7 seconds. 5 laps of fuel remaining. Okay, clear. Turbocharger is on its last legs. Let's try to keep mileage on it to a minimum. There's 3 laps of fuel remaining. Gap to the car in front is 1.9 seconds. two laps of fuel remaining. This is your final lap of the race. We think we may see some rain. ETA is about 15 minutes. Race over, take care of the car on the way in.
And so ends another Azerbaijan Grand Prix, a fascinating race and a well-deserved victory. Anthony Davidson, what helped them deliver this result, do you think?
Well, tyre management probably played quite a large role in the outcome of this one. As ever, it's not just about speed, it's all about maintaining that speed consistently over a stint, over a race distance. So being able to keep up the lap times while still being smooth on the controls and gentle on the tyres, that's really where the race was won today.
Red Bull are our winners today after showcasing some incredible driving. There's been a huge push from them lately to stay competitive with the other teams, and they're certainly proving themselves. And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the drivers' table. More points for Valtteri Bottas, further solidifying his lead at the top of the table. Now, let's discuss, Ant, who would you say is a contender for driver of the day?
I have to say Sebastian Vettel certainly caught my eye during today's race. Incredible driving.
It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. The lead at the top comes down after a strong weekend from the challenging pack. Meanwhile, good work from the owner drivers' team this weekend, who pushed themselves further up the order. It's been an absolutely wild weekend of Formula One action. I can't wait to see what's next.
The fans really seem to enjoy that. You made it look easy.
Who would you say is your biggest rival at the moment? You gained a lot of positions during the race, didn't you? You really looked in control of your car out there. Your team must be thrilled. Not a great day for your teammate today. What do you think went wrong? Great. Well, that's everything.